Ah, good evening, family. Hotep, hotep, hotep. So, thought I'd come and just do a quick video. It's 11:10, and I wanted to, stick to my plan of doing a video once a week. Okay. Now, one of the things that I wanted to talk about, one of the things that download from the primordial realm, okay, talk about worshiping the God in you. And again, am not going to stop saying this, that the age of Aquarius is a return of the crone mother Saturn that is here to undo the work, the damages, the psychological, the mental, and the spiritual and religious damage that was done to us when we were placed under the Piscean spell of the ignorance of religion. Okay? One of the things of the age of Aquarius, the return of the crone mother Saturn, is about taking your power back. And when you take your power back, you are expected to do the work to break the chains of psychological and mental slavery, okay, of which we were under. Now, there is some exciting changes happening on this planet. Let me go to my trusty little notes here. When we're talking about the planetary influences right now, one of the big thing is Pluto in Capricorn. Okay. And this Pluto in Capricorn is a powerful change. For it's a revolutionary energy. Okay? The last time Pluto was in Capricorn was between 1762 and 1778, the American Revolution. Okay? And of course, it changed the landscape. Now, Pluto moved into Capricorn on, in January 2008. And it will leave in 2024, 2024. Pluto's role in astrology is to transform and regenerate. Pluto tears down what no longer serves its purpose, often in dramatic fashion, freeing the path for something new to emerge. Okay. Capricorn rules over government and authority figures and also has links to the law, the military, you know what I'm saying, the geopolitical infrastructure. Okay. It also rules over karma and ancestry. Okay. These changes are often noisy, disruptive, and sometimes scary. Okay, and I'm just going to give, some examples. What I saw was just wonderful. Was not wonderful to those people it happened to, but it was wonderful for me viewing it. I was pinching my nipples. I ain't even gonna lie. I saw a restaurant where the entire staff walked out of this restaurant and they just quit. The day of the debt wage slave is coming to an end. This is where, and I can't get off McDonald's jock. And the reason I keep using them as an example, because they are a gross representation of slave labor. Okay? And when I say slave labor, they can afford to pay the people much more than they have been paying them. When you're paying somebody, a little punk ass $7.50 minimum wage, $8. Where are you going to live with that? You can't rent a small ass studio apartment. You can't even get a used car. And yet still people are overworked and underpaid. They have gotten away with it, this establishment, everything from Amazon to all the big, banking, finance, the people. I have a sister friend that works in corporate America, and to see how hard she works and is just underpaid in positions that is oftentimes nepotistic, that is dominated by a certain group of people. The same thing with academia. Okay? The academia was reading something about, how academia is really, and it's true. It's a racist environment, okay? A racist environment that is largely nepotistic, okay? And so Pluto is here to change all that bullshit. Okay? And I'm just going to jump around for a minute. I seen some congressman, some white dude, and he was trying to come for LeBron. But what I'm going to tell you bitches, you ain't coming for LeBron. Okay? Because when he said about that cop that he was next, he didn't mean, y'all know what he meant. He meant that he was going to be next, that he was going to be like the punk ass Duvin, okay, that sat on George Floyd's neck, that was going to be charged. Okay, see what is happening now? You're going to have to start charging. And see, this is not about white fragility, because I am just amazed of how fragile some of these, and to the rest of the white people, if it don't fly, if it don't apply, let it fly. Okay, because we're going to have a conversation about this bullshit. When you have a brother like LeBron, now, first of all, LeBron ain't said nothing that ain't nobody said. Because as Nubians, we're tired of living underneath this racist ass environment. We're tired of seeing these renegade cops murking our people, unarmed citizens. That's not what they were put there, protect and serve. And don't get me wrong, you do have good cops. You understand? Of course, yes. And it's like any organization that has its rotten apples. But what has happened, the rotten apples have not been dealt with. They have been allowed to run amok, unchecked. Well, now they're going to have to start getting checked. Because, see, this is the law of the universe. This is the law of humanity. See, this is why there's Maatian laws of morality. You feel me? Because if the checks and balance are not done, the sleeping giant, which is us, is going to wake up. And what you don't want is us waking up in hope mode. Because study history and see, just what the black devils can do that will make it pale in comparison to anything that has ever been done by any other devils on this planet. And there's devils in every race. And what it is, we are tired of living up underneath this ridiculous, unjust, racist ass energy. Because racism, aside from being a mental illness, it costs money. You understand? Because in the future, you will not be able to get away with what you have been getting away with in this country for the last 400 years. You understand? Things are changing. There are planetary alignments that are lined up and geared towards change. The age of Aquarius is the age, okay, of the gods awaken, the mortal gods, us that are here to take our power back. You understand? And so, when it talks about worshiping the God in you, okay, this is about you worshiping your inner God. You worshiping yourself. Maya Angelou once said, you have got to love yourself enough to come to your own self-defense. You understand? So when we look at these plutonic energy and this Saturnian energy, these are massive energies being brought to the planet to invoke change, upheaval. I went to Wendy's yesterday. My kids wanted some nuggets. And there was only three people working in Wendy's. You know why? Because everybody is tired of being overworked and underpaid. And you all have gotten away with it for so long that it just, the bow breaks. And I know Biden was telling people, you know, with all these stimulus checks they've been throwing at people like strippers in a strip club, you know, and the PP loans some people have been getting, and, you know, that now, you know, people have got to get back to work because they have been abusing the system. And so your benefits are going to be cut or something to that nature. If you don't, your unemployment benefits are going to be cut, you know. But see, what the people, and the age of Aquarius is a revolutionary age when the collective wake up and realize 99% is being, 95% or 94% is being ruled over by 3%. That's inequality. And this is in all sectors. Listen, I'm a former healthcare worker. I left because of the racism, because honestly, if I didn't leave, I would have caught a case. And since orange is not my color, I wasn't, if I'm going to kill somebody, I'm going to kill a bunch of people. I'm not going to jail for just one person. Oh no, I'm going to be that person, you know, that will go on a roof with a rifle. Okay, just picking folks off. And seeing that I have no intentions of doing that. Okay, because it's not even worth it. You know what I'm saying? But if I was to go there, that's how I would choose to go out. It wouldn't be for just one random racist ass person. Oh no, it'll be a bunch of people. Okay? And so, you know, when we look at this age of Aquarius, this is about taking back your power. Again, I'm going to use McDonald's. You know what I'm saying? You've been paying people the minimum wage. You got people 27, 30, still living at home with their parents, working these low wage jobs because they can't afford, you know what I'm saying, to get even a small studio apartment. It's ridiculous. And you have gotten away with, when you think about the amount of people that come through McDonald's on a daily basis, they make a few million dollars a day. And you can't afford to pay your workers $18, $19 an hour? Why do people need to go to college, that racist-ass academic environment, to where they make it so difficult? You know, because first of all, the schools in the inner cities are undereducated. So when you finally do get to college, you got to take 2 years of prerequisites. That 2 years of tying yourself down in debt before you finally get to what you want to study. And then you're lucky if you come out and get a job paying you what you're truly worth. You know what I'm saying? And so once folks have, you know, awakened to who they are and have decided to reclaim their power, it's a wrap for the so-called establishment, because things are changing at a rapid level. Now you look at these fools over in the Middle East, the Israelis, the Palestinians. I don't understand, you know, this battle that's been going on since 1967. Because really, everybody that's born on this planet is a resident here. No one place truly belongs to anybody. And so while all this money is being sent, you know, to Israel, 3 point something billion every year, that they can have a dome that when the Hamas people rain down the rockets, it blocks You know what I'm saying? This is what the tax dollars is going to. But if the tax dollars were cut, they would be forced to get along, as they should. No one person is better than anybody. The Palestinians is not better than the Israelis. The Israelis are not better than a Palestinian. Why this continuous fighting? And why are other people supporting, you know what I'm, other people's tax dollars supporting, you know what I'm saying? This fighting. It's ridiculous. So there are changes that's coming to this planet. I saw again, what was it, over there somewhere in the Middle East where I think it was Afghanistan someplace, that they bombed a school that killed 50 or 60 little girls. What kind of hatred for the divine feminine? What kind of mindset would bomb a school of little girls that people like this actually exist on the planet that would even have a that level of wickedness and malevolence to some innocent children that 60 or 50 mothers have to bury their daughters because some deranged or persons that decided they're going to bomb a school with girls. See, these are the changes that's going to have to be made on the planet. And I'm telling you, when women do finally take back the planet, it will be a capital punishment to kill a woman. You're automatically going to be put to death. Oh, there's a lot of changes that's going to come down the pipe. See, we have to really realize everything now is frequency. We're fully in 5D. You understand? And so anything that you desire, you got to be vibrating on that frequency. If you want to see peace, you got to vibrate on a peaceful existence. If you want prosperity, you got to be vibrating on a prosperous energy. That means being kind, being generous. You understand? There are big changes that's coming and we have to change with it. That means if you want to see the change in the world, you have got to be the change within yourself because the planet can no longer. You know what's going to happen over there in the Middle East with the Israelis and the Palestinian fighting? It's just going to be a giant earthquake that kill off the majority of them over there if y'all can't get along. That this is because mother is truly tired, and this is what is going to happen. Because, see, the earth, because she is a living, breathing entity, okay, cannot continue to withstand this kind of raw hatred and war. For what? What the hell are, I don't care about centuries-old grudges. We're here now. Why can't both people live in group set of people live in peace? And this is just wherever. Why are people going around bombing a school with little girls? You know what I'm saying? Why are they not hunted down and executed? Okay. And so let me segue on something else. I want to show you the power of words. The power. You know, the Bible says life and death is in the power of the tongue. This is real, the heck up. I'm gonna give you an example. The other day, some dudes in Thailand, I think they were Thai, or one of those Asian countries, and they were submarine pilots that they went out on a run, and all 53 of them died. The submarine sank. But here's where it gets really eerie. 2 weeks before that, they were actually singing a song about goodbye. I hope we meet again. Don't cry for me. I'm gonna miss you. And it's normally a song that is sung at funerals. Did they put that energy inadvertently out there? Because I know even with my son Amun-Ra, his Heka game is strong. And I have to tell him sometimes, son, don't joke around like that because you'll get pissed off at somebody and throw some shit out there and something really diabolical happened to them. Please don't do it. You're not trying to rack up bodies just like that, just being frivolous, because you are going to have to live up underneath that energy. Or when you do have your children, they're going to live up underneath that energy. So watch your tongue. You understand? Especially now, the day and time that we are in, we have got to be so careful of what we put out there because it can manifest quickly like that. Now, while some things take time to manifest, there's other things that can literally manifest. Okay? I look at today, my oldest daughter gave birth to my eighth grandson. Gave birth to my eighth grandchild, who was a little boy, and he's actually was born on my father's. Today would have been my father's 78th birthday if he was alive. Well, wait a minute, my mother's 75, so my father would have been, yeah, probably about 78. And today is his birthday. So she gave birth actually on my dad's birthday. And so I just got a new grandchild, my eighth. You know what I'm saying? So I'm pretty psyched about that, you know? And I wanted to talk about the upcoming energy that is coming up. Just one second. Let me pause this. Is this the pause button? No, but it. All right. Now let me get my trusty little notes here because there's some good stuff getting ready to come down the pike. Okay. Now, besides all that Capricornian Saturnian energy, Neptune, no, not Neptune, Jupiter. Okay. The money planet is going to be in Pisces, which is a very fruitful sign, okay, for the next 2 months. Okay. On May 13th, 2021, Jupiter enters Pisces, the sign of its domicile. Jupiter is in Pisces for a brief stay until July 28th, 2021. Y'all better get this money. Get this money, okay? In the next 2.5 months, we will get our first taste of this transit. Okay? Jupiter then re-enters Pisces on December 29th, 2021, where it stays in Pisces until May 10th, 2022. And again, back in Pisces from October 28th, 2022 until December 20th, 2020. Jupiter and Neptune in Pisces, there is magic everywhere. Many people look forward to Jupiter and Pisces, and for good reason, because Jupiter is in its domicile in Pisces, so it feels at home in this sign. This is, ooh, this is like, yes, okay. So this is where you all should be doing a lot of your manifestation rituals for money. Okay? And Neptune, that plays a part in the manifestation. Because Neptune is one of our planets of spirituality, and it is ruled over by that Piscean energy. So it and Pisces, Cancer, and Scorpio are the most fruitful signs because of that water energy. So for those of you, let's get ready to get the Shasta's treasure, my girl Shasta. Okay. Shasta's treasure. Okay. On eBay. And this is her money drawing incense. And honey, this is the truth root. Okay. The money draw. This is the money drawing incense. And she's on Etsy. Shasta's treasures. Okay. It's $14 each, but two for $25. And I got probably about eight of these bottles. And also, let me give a shout out to my sister, Ms. Divine, Miss Royal, the Divine Oracle. Okay. Website www.missroyal. Okay. At thedivineoracle.com. And this is her card. Let me put that up there for those folks that wanna, let me see, I can put that up there. This is my goddess here, locked and loaded. Let me make sure I'm putting that up there. Yes. Miss Royal, the Divine Oracle. Okay. This is her phone number, 843-452-5941. Her email, Miss Royal, okay, 7771, okay, at gmail.com. Let me make sure. Yeah, 7771 at gmail.com. Now, let me tell you about this sister. Her motherfucking prosperity candles are the bomb.com. Yo, for real. The beef. Jamaicans, we call our sisters the beef. Okay? Yo, my sister sent me some prosperity candles. And, you know, Spirit told me not to come on here talking about no money. And, you know, we ain't got Bezos money. You know, Gates money. But still, it's a little something for us. You know what I'm saying? Where she sent me this candle, couple of candles actually, and I lit it on the 13th, and by the 27th, I had made like $7,000. You know what I'm saying? Money's still rolling in. I think in 1 month, I made like $10,000. You know what I'm saying? This is a type that her energy that she puts on it, the herbs, you know, and whatever ritual she does over it as a oracle, okay? That can move some stuff. Now, here is the thing about money rituals, okay, is that the frequency around you has to be cleared. See, for me, it was no big deal, this money coming in, because honestly, I had been doing the ancestral work and my altar is lit. So when I put that candle on it, it was like, yo, what's up? You want this? Let's get this. You understand? And there's still more coming in, and there's even going to be even more coming in. Because as a matter of fact, I just ordered 4 more candles from her. Because I'm telling you, I'm hitting every last one of these Piscean, Jupiterian energy that's coming through. Because this is all money. And it's in a Taurus energy. Taurus is money. We're dealing with Oshun. We're dealing with Hathor. You understand what I'm saying? We're dealing with Shango. Type energy, Shangoian, and in the age of Aquarius, that's ruled over by Shango. This is the age where, because see, what we're witnessing is that it's a fall of one system with another that will be in place. And when the fall of this ridiculous consumeristic, imperialistic, capitalistic energy falls, and it will. Okay, there is going to be new careers, new forms of making money that are going to spring up around holistic and spiritual themes. So for those of you that want to get this work as metaphysical counselor, okay, check out the University of Metaphysics, where you can learn to do hypnosis, to do past life regressions, and all of this stuff, okay? Because it's going to be a spiritual revolution where people are going to be needing help of how to tap in and to revoke these ancestral contracts. And as I'm saying this, let me just, I just went and got some of this ancestral money from this group called the Galacticus. Damn, what did I do with their information? Let me see. What is this? It's called the Galacticus. Galacticus Sales in Staten Island. And I bought this big ass ancestral money. You feel me? This is the Bank of Heaven. Promotes karmic ratification. This is a big ass ancestral money. And what I have done, I got one of these laminated and I placed it on my ancestral altar. This is the Jade Emperor Mazu karmic ratification. And you know, the first Indo-Asians were Nubians, honey. So, hey, listen, We dealing with nothing outside of self, okay? So when we dealing with this, it promotes karmic ratification. That means the wrapping up of karmic debt. This is what you want to do. And I think this is $48 quadrillion. It's some real craziness, okay? And yesterday, you know, it was an ancestral day. And this is where you go and you download, okay, the Earth Center, okay, the Kemetic Calendar, okay? The Kemetic Calendar. It's downloaded for free. And you can upgrade it, okay, for I think $3.99. Already owned upgraded version, and you know, but it's won't transfer to my other phone because I did switch phone. But let me go down here. And yesterday, the ritual, the ancestral ritual that I did, okay. Let me go in here. Yesterday, okay, on the 12th of May, okay, when you click on it, it's an ancestral holy day, okay, the ancestral holy day, okay, which is May 12th. The next one that's coming up is May 22nd, okay, which is Saturday, May 22nd, and for you, to get this work done, okay? So when you order, and I don't know much about this brother, the Galacticus. I don't know who told me about him or something, but I ran across and I saw that the ancestral money, and seeing that I'm a regular, you know, I throw money, ancestral money, and my ancestors like they were strippers in a strip club. So I know when I get over there, I better have a big ass mansion, you know what I'm saying, driving a nice car, you know, because as in life, so in death, you don't want your ancestors on the whole stroll over in the astral realm, you know, to get some money. You want them to be nice. And so when we do these karmic ratification, this is where we are also helping to rectify karmic debt. And see, I think I paid for this. I think it's like, it's a bunch of them. I think I might have paid $135. See, I invest in myself. I invest in my spirituality. That's why I am richly blessed and prosperous, because I invest in my spirituality. Okay? And so this is my way of even giving back to others, to bless others. Because when I do readings and I do an Akashic record reading and I tap into somebody's Akashic and I can see in past lives some of the stuff that they did. Okay. I remember I read for this white girl and I saw that she was a funerary priestess back in Kemet. Okay, where she was part of the funerary priestess to help perfume the body. And of course, she looked different back then, you know what I'm saying? And she had, you know, was helping Anubis and all of them, you know what I'm saying? And Maat and all of them. And so, you know, it made sense as to why in this lifetime, she was, you know, actually going to school to be a mortician, and why she had always been attracted to cemetery and the dead was, yeah, because you was a past life priestess of the dead. Okay, dig it. And so for me, as a diviner, as a oracle, you know what I'm saying, to tap back into somebody's ancestral path, whether they're in Akashic record, or for me to tap into somebody's ancestral path to hear what messages their ancestors have, what kind of energy is in the ancestral line that needs to be elevated. Because now that we are in the day and time of having this information, we did not have this information 400 years ago, unless you were in secret societies. We have it now. So now it is up to you to do the work to elevate your ancestors. You know what I'm saying? To do these karmic ratification to where we, now do the work to revoke these karmic, these spiritual contracts. Okay, and the reason we do this is so that we clear the path for the next generation, that when Amun-Ra and his children will live a nice life, my daughter Zipporah will live a nice life, my son Heru will live a nice life, my daughter Hathor, you know, my grandchildren, my lineage, I am clearing the path for my lineage. Okay. I don't know how the sound is going to sound because I've already ordered a microphone that will be coming, so my videos will be getting a little bit better, okay? But that is the energy I wanted to come and talk about tonight, about, you know, jumping from topic to topic. But really, it's about you doing the work to worship the God in you. And again, I can't get off the singing bowl tip. And I'm just going to get on it again, okay? Get on it again. The ritual that Spirit gave me, because I just bought some singing bowl. What it was I couldn't sleep at night because I have really bad sleep apnea. And it's severe sleep apnea. But then Spirit was like, when they gave me this big-ass mask like Thanos to put on, I was like, I can't sleep with this because it brings back memories of my violent first marriage, when, you know, my first used to like really like strangle me and choke me. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, yo, this shit feel like I'm being strangled all over again, so I ain't doing it. Okay. And Spirit was like, you know what, go back to using your singing bowl, because I put them down for a while. So I noticed when I took my singing bowl, it just cleared all that stagnant energy. But as I began working with my singing bowl, they came and they was giving me all types of ritual. And I know I've done this before, but I'm going to do it again because I want folks at home to really get this stuff. Okay? Put your singing bowl on your toilet. Put the toilet seat down. And you're going to take off your pants, your drawers. And you are going to knock your singing bowl like so, and you are going to squat. You are going to squat, and you are going to deal with the energies internally, breaking up stagnant energy. For you men that's been sexually molested and raped, you need to do that with your butt, okay? And for women also, you know what I'm saying, with your yoni and with your butt, you know what I'm saying, that you want to, because see, here's the thing. When you have been raped, sexually molested, whatever, you know what I'm saying? What it is, it's now an energy. That energy never dies. And so your body has absorbed this energy. And this is why it affects you. You understand? Because the act itself is horrible, but the energy that it leaves behind, you feel me? So what that does is like taking a hammer to a glass and shattering it. It now breaks up that stagnant energy. It breaks it up and it removes it out of the body. It has no choice. It can't, because now, you know, the energy that's been sitting there stagnant, it must now be broken up and it must now be released from the body. And this is where, hello, Hathor. Come say hi to the people. And this is where you now, you know what I'm saying? Go outside, my little hattie batty. My little hattie batty. Say hi.
Hi.
What's going on? Was you sleeping?
No, there's some pain.
Huh?
In pain.
In pain of what? What kind of pain?
My stomach.
Oh. All right. And so this is where you get a chance. And you are to do your sun rituals, because our people did sun rituals. I seen a meme with a white guy, and he had his legs all the way up, you know, sunning his nether regions to the sun. We did that. Witches do that. Putting your yoni to the window to catch the moonlight that beams down on the yoni. Well, now that we're in the 24,000-year sun cycle of the divine feminine, okay, where she is once again returned from her slumber from the underworld, okay, You are to sun your nether regions because there's a particular frequency of the sun. The sun feels very different, okay? And the ancient Kemetics, they talked about this, how, you know, when they built the pyramids, how when the sun hit the top of the pyramid, it did something. So there is change. It's like Bob Marley said, there's a natural mystic blowing through the air. If you listen carefully, you will hear. So when we do this video, whether it's me, Divine Oracle, the brother, Hippie Astrology, Conjure Queen, and there's so many others that's out there putting out this information. What's the other sister name? The Virgo, Lucid Living. There's so many people out here putting out the information. You understand? And so really, this is about for your edification, for your elevation, because as you elevate your ancestors and you do these ratification, you also elevate yourself. You also clear the karmic debt for yourself, okay? Because you do inherit your karmic ancestral debt. Because it's passed down through the bloodline, especially where there's been curses in the bloodline. Now, what I did when I did this karmic ratification, and my fellow priestess, sister, you know, Miss Divine Royal, Miss Divine Oracle, okay, she sent me some oils, and her oils are thebomb.com. And so when I did her all-purpose oil, you know, I got a prosperity oil and all of this. And I just put some, you know, rub some on my hands and I go over and I, you know, do my thing. And I do my little shamlama ding dong. And so they gave me a ritual when I lit this and I put it in my big ass singing bowl. And then I took it outside to a tree and I spread the ashes by the tree. Okay? Because once I started reworking with my singing bowl, they started coming to me and giving me rituals. They was like, okay, put some water. You understand? And when you put the water in it, you use different crystals for different purposes. So when you put a rose quartz in here, you are infusing in your nether regions love your body, love your temple. When you let me see, you know, my Oshun hat here, okay, and now it reverberates from my crown chakra all the way to my root chakra. Oh yes. I'm almost pinching my nipples to this. You know what I'm saying? Because this feels so good. And this is the work that we're doing. Because see, this is the age of learning how to breathe properly. Taking deep breaths from the bottom. Your root chakra, your sternum coming up in your chest and bringing it outward. Because if you notice, when you go through your day-to-day existence, you're just breathing in short gasp of breath. You're not even breathing properly. You're actually shortening your lifespan because there's not enough oxygen going to your brains and your organ. It causes premature aging. You understand? It takes time. It takes years off your life. You know what I'm saying? Months or whatever. You understand? Your body is not fully getting oxygen. And being that we're in the age of Aquarius, this is an air type energy. You understand? We want to be breathing properly. You know what I'm saying? This is where Tantra is going to come in. This is where yoga is going to come in. This is where veganism, vegetarianism, because it's a lighter energy. Everything has to be lightened. And so we have to lighten our bodies. You understand? We have to walk up on the earth lightly. You understand? It's a lighter vibration that you have to be in tune. One of the things the primordial mother said to me recently, everything now is frequency. You want a new car? You have to be vibrating on that frequency. You want your house? You have got to be vibrating on that frequency so that the universe can open the channels for you. You understand? Providing, of course, you do the work. You understand? Because this is also a time of work. This is a time in the age of Aquarius where we must go back and take our power back of what was done to us in religion. That spell of the Piscean age that was casted over us. That was spell. Because see, what has happened is they worked on our emotions. Now in the age of Aquarius, this is about detaching from emotion. We cannot use emotionalism. And this is where, you know, when I was my fellow priestess, Miss Divine Oracle, she did a live last night and I was able to catch the tail end of it because I was busy doing readings all day yesterday. And I managed to catch her tail end. And what she was saying, we got to be careful what we put in this. You understand? This is why you look at the news, you know, and some are real and some are manufactured because things are being done to trigger you because they have been used to controlling you through your emotions, triggering you so you can react. You know, I was on Instagram or something and there was a post, some racist stuff and all the black people were up in arms. And it's like, really? Y'all are not past this yet? Y'all are still being triggered with this? Really? Because see, here's my thing. If you study your history and you know exactly who you are and you descended from gods, can nobody trigger you? Trigger you for what? You have got, and see, this is where Saturn is coming. And let me just go in here and read my crone mother. And I do a lot of Saturnian rituals. Love her. Okay. First of all, in the age of Aquarius, you're going to have to work with Saturn because Saturn is the ancient ruler of Aquarius. You can't go nowhere until you working with Saturn. And my thing is telling me it's sun time. It's sun time right now. We're now in the energy of the sun. Let me again, because I've said it before in previous video, and I'm going to keep saying it. Keywords with the Saturnian energy is discipline, learning how to discipline yourself. So when you see some shit, it should not rock you. Patience, overcoming obstacle, responsibility, maturity, ancestors, foundation, structure, organization, stability, command, duty, honor, law, restriction, deprivation, depriving yourself of fuckery, honor, punctuality, obligations, principle. You know, we Jamaicans, we always say, it's not that, at a principle. We fight on principle. You understand? And so this is where you are going to have to go in and undo the damage of the last 2,000 years when you were placed underneath that spell. The Bible is one of the greatest book of the occult, but you got to know how to use that because you can mess around and curse yourself with the Bible. You can place some serious obstacles in your path if you don't really know how to read and decode that and how to manipulate because the words were changed around because before it said God, it was Great Mother because it was written by our foremothers. Now, and I'm going to do a video about that, about for the sisters. Because I've had sisters that, oh, I don't know if I'm not a witch and I'm this and that. Listen, you ain't got to do all that. You can stay in Christianity. You can stay in Islam. You understand? But take it back to its original holistic sources. You going to stay in Islam? Well, you ain't going to be dealing with Muhammad and what's the other one there? Allah? You're going to have to take it back to Alat al-Uzen Manat, when we did rituals underneath the moonlight. You understand? Even though we're working by the sun. So for all you people that's been working by the moon, because the moon is a weaker energy, you understand the sun is more vibrant. So you don't switch nothing. Keep doing your ritual, but do them now by the sun. You understand? And now, if you want to stay in Christianity, oh, stay in Christianity, but you know Mary is the top dog, honey. Ruth and all of them. You ain't going through Jesus. What's this fuckery they talk about in religion? Talk about, oh, a woman came from a man rib. When the woman carried a man and gave birth to him, oh, she come from femme ribs. So if you want to stay, then you're going to have to learn to take it back to its original holistic sources, because when it was first created by our mothers, it was very holistic. It was like going to a Buddhist temple. Can you imagine? Okay? And you can incorporate your singing bowls and your crystals and lighten your candles with your Bibles. And yes, Mary, the mother, Shekinah, Judaism. It's all ours. And listen, we coming back for all our shit. Okay? Because I am one of the biggest occultists on the planet, but my Bible get a lot of work out. I will bust you down in a heartbeat with my Bible. You understand? I ain't got to light a candle on your bitch ass. I ain't got to do all of that. I ain't got to put you in a jar and brown bottle your ass and take you to the cemetery. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I ain't got to invoke some shit on your head. I just quickly just go on my Bible and get it and bust you down. Bust you upside your head with it. I done made people's car crash. Engines blew up. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I done did some damage with the trusty Bible. Because it is the greatest book of the occult. If you know how to decode that, you don't need a goddamn thing else. Because everything is in there. Okay? So, back to LeBron. I'm going to need you bitches to hop off LeBron's nuts, okay? Because he ain't saying nothing that other black folks ain't been saying. This is a man that has a black wife and black children. You understand? And we're tired of seeing our people get murked. Deal with the stuff and fix it, okay? Before you awaken the Hulk. Because once the Hulk has been awakened and that switch get flipped on, it's not going to be nice. Because when the other side gets activated, remember Hathor is the goddess of wine and beauty? Because I remember when I was carrying her, I was going to name her Sekhmet, and the mothers were like, ancestors were like, whoa! You know what I'm saying? Name her Hathor. Don't even put Sekhmet in her name. Because she already walking with some crazy shit. From your mama bloodline and her father bloodline. It's just two crazy Jamaicans there. And it's a lot of fire. And so we don't want to just Hathor, Hathor, Hathor. And she walk with the same Oshun I walk with, Ibu Koli. Okay? And so, you know, this is a wonderful time to be alive, because I am telling you, it's some changes getting ready to come down the pike. I mean, I am loving this Pluto in Capricorn, because she is getting ready to bust some shit up on the planet. You understand? And I am here for all of it. I got my front row seat with my popcorn. I got my front row seat with my popcorn. Let me go back here. And I am loving it. My mother is here visiting for a month. And we ain't got into a dust up yet. She's behaving herself. Mom? No, she fell asleep. It's good. She haven't yet, and she ain't, you know, said nothing about my altar. She is being very good. Okay. Let me see where we got the Kabylan. Now we ain't talking about the Kabylan. What is this? Yeah, let's go back in here to today's planetary. And this is by a sister named Kelly Fox, that does, you know, astrology, the skies today. You know, Mercury is in Gemini, you know, which Mercury is, you know, in her home sign of Gemini. Okay, Venus is in Gemini. The moon is in Gemini. We got the sun in Taurus. Mars is in Cancer. Mars is uncomfortable in Cancer because it's too emotional. Okay. And Jupiter in Pisces. Yes. Saturn in Aquarius. Uranus is in Taurus. Okay. And let me tell you something about that Uranus in Taurus, honey. That is also the money sign. It's been a long time coming, but we're about to finally see a push for greater global equality. See, that's what's getting ready to come. Global equality. Let me tell you something. First of all, there should be no poor people on this planet. You know why? Because this planet is rich in resources. And you got a few that control the wealth of the majority that should be evenly distributed amongst everybody. When Uranus transits Taurus, we can be sure of one thing: the establishment is in for a shock. Taurus is a zodiac sign traditionally connected with finance, banking, building, and astrological Uranus energy is the stuff of revolution, upheaval, democracy, radical change, and popular protests. You see all these protests been going on? Now, I don't protest because all it takes is one crazy person to come up and do some crazy shit, and ain't no police going to be firing no rubber bullets and busting me upside the head. I let who want to protest do that. That's not my thing. Uranus entered Taurus in May 2018, and we have already seen the beginnings of mass protests on numerous issues around the world. Taurus is an earth sign, and concern over the future of our planet is mobilizing minds like never before. By the time Uranus leaves Taurus in late April 2026, we may have witnessed the 1% shaken out of their complacency and greed. Okay? As ordinary individuals feel empowered to make their voices heard. Okay? My battery is running low. Let me plug in my computer before she goes dead. I would hate her to go dead while I'm in the middle of my spiel. Okay? Yas. Yas. Okay? So this is some good shit right here. Okay? Mm-hmm. The 1% will be shaken out of their complacency and greed. As ordinary individuals feel empowered to make their voices heard. This is the age of the collective, when we're all gonna get together. Black, white, yellow, red, purple, it don't matter. They can't keep us apart anymore to keep us fighting amongst each other. You understand? The collective is going to come together because the collective is going to have to, you know, redistribute this stuff so everybody get a fair shake. Driven by the decent values that most of humanity shares, because most of us do share the same values. Taurus is big on values. Change may start to feel unstoppable. Expect social media to play a large part, okay, in organizing, okay, in organizing this avalanche of feeling. Uranian energy is nothing if not tech savvy. There's an environmental feel here too, of course, and a growing recognition that the world needs holistic, innovative, creative solutions, not just move to the same old. Oh, we done with that. We gonna have real change, for real, not more of the same. Democrat, Republican, same thing, same point. Real change, a real party for the people, by the people. You understand? As more and more of us harness Uranian energy to speak up and speak out, refusing to know our place, our complacency to look the other way. You understand? The powers that be will have to take notice to channel this potentially explosive energy positively. Will take some very skillful world leadership. On a personal level, the Uranus in Taurus transit brings value shift for many of us. What we thought was right, or what we thought we believed, may change in light of new information. And remember, that's a good thing. Because what it is, again, I'm jumping on McDonald's tip. You know, things like McDonald's, Costco, Burger King, Wendy's, you know what I'm saying? All of these, why should my kids, you know, first of all, like I'll give my son, Amin-Ra is not in the least bit interested in going to college, nor is he interested in going in the military. You know what I'm saying? And so it's like, why should those be the only two options? You understand? For him to so-called earn a decent living. Why he can't just go to a trade school? Because I'm going to point him in the direction of going to get a trade in welding. You know what I'm saying? And so, or whatever he's interested in, and make that happen. You know, why is it that people should not be able to earn a decent living? You understand? And be able to afford even the basics to drive a reliable car, you know. And we're going to have to get away from our dependency on fossil fuels. I mean, just here in Atlanta, shit, I drove to 3 different gas stations today and couldn't find no gas. I was driving all around yesterday. Everywhere was out of gas. You know what I'm saying? Because of this stuff. You know, we have the means and the ways and the technology to power cars on electricity. We have the ways and means to do a lot of things. There is a lot of new technology that they're withholding from us. But it will all have to come out in the wash, because this is the day and time that we are in. You understand? This is a very exciting time, but it's very scary for the 1%. You see, Elon Musk's ass, his ass was up on Saturday Night Live. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. His ass must have been bored or something. Bill Gates, with his crazy ass, he's getting ready to get a divorce from his wife, if it's even a real divorce or shifting of resources, because, you know, they might be getting ready to come for his ass, for his fuckery on the planet. You understand? So it's a lot of stuff, and it's going to be shaken up. The monarchy, that's going to come to an end. Why you need a monarchy? You know what I'm saying? For what? You know what I'm saying? And it's going to be real change, for real, for real, where everybody should be able to participate and get an even shake. No one on this planet, I don't give a damn where you're from. From the continent to the obscure parts of Europe to the Caribbean islands, everywhere in between, no one should be living in poverty. Not when our planet is so wealthy, because we got 1% controlling stuff while the masses can barely eck. No, we're not feeling that. And so things are going to change. And this is good news. So, you know, I just wanted to touch on that to do, how long has this video been going, you know? I did an hour. All righty, because I said I was, you know, working on shortening my video, and I can't wait till my new microphone come so I can, you know, have my video sounding really nice, you know? And so, again, for those of you who are interested in being counselors, hypnotherapist, because see, with the fall of this capitalistic, imperialistic, you know, deadweight slave energy, we are more careers, more ways of making a living that are going to spring up around more holistic spiritual themes, where we have 7 billion people on this planet. So we are going to need quite a few more diviners, holistic therapists, hypnotherapists, to have you tap back and to go back and to release some stuff, you know, all the spiritual modality. You understand? This is what is going to be taking place, you know? So it's a very exciting time. And the 1%, they got to come up off that loot. You know what I'm saying? I'm still waiting for my PP loan that they have been throwing at people like strippers. And every time I go on Womply, okay, Womply, and put in my identification, they're telling me can't verify. And I've done that about 60 times, and y'all still can't verify my shit? No, I'm not feeling that, okay? Don't let me have to go on my Bible on Womply, because I've been known to hex up places. I put people out of business with my Bible. So, until next time, same bat time, same bat channel. Oh, before I go, and this group that I am going to be creating later on in the year for the women, you know, and I'm going to have my priest, they're going to be doing something for the men, because I would love to do something for the men, but honestly, there is some harsh conversation that needs to be had for the men, and I don't think, y'all ain't ready to hear this, because there's been a lot of downloads that have come down where you all went from being gods, you know what I'm saying, to the fuckery that's going on. So, and in this day and age, this is where we once again elevate and activate our living gods within us to become living gods on this earth, walking in a holistic energy, okay, with our Maatian moral laws, okay, because we have fallen so far away. And this is an energy of death, okay? Because Mother is coming through with her sickle and her psyche, and she's clearing people off. You understand? And so this is what it is. If you cannot elevate, then you got to get up off of here. You know what I'm saying? And there is going to be a lot of themes around the killing of the divine feminine, the way how the divine feminine is treated on this planet and is oppressed is going to stop, okay? I mean, I'm just saying, the divine feminine that brings life to this planet, that is treated with such disregards, bombing schools with little girls, killing the divine feminine, killing these young girls, nah, man, we can't have this. We can't have this. And trust me, I won't live to see it. But, you know, when we do take this planet back, it's going to be a capital offense to kill women. And one of the downloads that I got from Mother, you know, that one day, a man, when he goes on a date, he's going to have to go with his little briefcase, his folder, okay? And he's going to have to show that he's been through counseling, nurturing classes, sensitivity, his education, whatever, he's going to have to show that he is worthy to be chosen as a mate. Right now, and for the last few thousand years, y'all have had where, you know what I'm saying? But that is going to change. Because, see, right now, it's murking season. Mother's here murking a lot of y'all. Y'all see all these rappers dying off? You know what I'm saying? I heard from a sister friend today, this evening, when we were in one of our sessions, you know, that some young rapper, 21 years old, you know, got killed. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just this. Remember, Saturn also rules over death. And the image of Saturn is the Grim Reaper, okay? The Saturnian energy that comes through with her sickle or her scythe to just clear shit off. You know what I'm saying? So this is the energy, and this is where you got to protect your neck. You got to make sure that you are vibrating on this frequency of equality, of love, and compassion for your fellow human beings. Because the day of hatred and racism and all of this stuff, oh, it's coming to an end, baby. Because, see, that energy is also going to start killing these people that is vibrating on that frequency. You understand? It's going to start killing them. You understand? Because you've never seen a vibrant racist. They all just look mean and tight in the face. They all just look ugly and old and decrepit. You understand? And so there's big changes coming to this planet. And I am here for all of it. So until next time, same bat time, same bat channel. Hope you enjoyed this video, all right? All right.